Welcome back to the show. It is 6:30 and we have breaking news. London right now in the midst of an unfolding emergency, record-breaking temperatures sparking these fires.
Goodness me. Let's go to CNN correspondent Bianca Nobilo, who joins us now from Wennington, which is east of the city. Bianca, thanks for your time this morning. I mean, it's hard to believe what we're seeing. What's it like on the ground there?
I was just speaking to somebody who was telling me that one of the residents who lived in the houses behind me, many of which are now destroyed as of blazes over the last few hours, around 100 acres worth has been ignited behind me. He took just a teddy bear and a photograph of his mother because those were the only possessions that he had time to retrieve. We're seeing fire trucks all around us. Earlier today, the London Fire Brigade didn't have one single fire engine left. I spoke to a senior member of that brigade who does special rescue, who told me that he's never, ever experienced a time with this level of demand, even during the Grenfell Tower disaster in London, which I'm sure you guys will remember. So I've been at one of the sites of these fires. We've seen about 7 fire trucks in the last hour. They're still trying to contain the blaze, which has been jumping around. And of course, this is all caused in large part by the scorching, unprecedented heat that the country has been feeling today, which is making it even harder for all the firemen who are having to assist ambulances when people are getting stuck, claustrophobic and overheating, and also people discarding cigarettes, bottles, or little sparks from building works are setting wildfires alight all around the capital.
Bianca, you're detailing it perfectly this morning. Ali and I were watching it this morning before we came on air, and it looks like that Wennington, where you are, what, about 40 minutes drive out of London, this is in East London, it looks like that concentration of fires there was particularly bad.
It was, and actually I was speaking to somebody earlier whose daughter grew up here, and she was watching Sky News and recognised the houses of her childhood going up in flames from watching the television. And this area has been hit extremely badly, and it was explained to me by the pub owner and local resident who I was speaking to just before I went live with you guys, that it's because there was an area where there was a lot of dry wood, essentially like a trench around many acres of dry land and like dry arable farming. And when that lit up, it essentially created a large ring of fire, which was leading to more and more blaze throughout the day. And it's been so hard to contain because even though there's a fire station here, all of the fire trucks here had already been sent to other areas of London to deal with the unprecedented heat and fires. So when one broke out here, they didn't have them. So then they had to wait, it expanded, and obviously they're always unpredictable. And there's been a lot of wind today as well, but it's particularly severe here. The smoke has been so thick, and these people are just utterly dumbfounded that on the outskirts of London, they're experiencing these temperatures and their memories and houses and belongings burning up. It's something they never thought they'd experience.
And look, it's something that we have, unfortunately, a great understanding of here. When the fires spread like that, they quickly become uncontrollable. But look, it's 9:30 at night where you are. It's 29 degrees. There must be grave fears, with this heat wave expected to continue for the next couple of days at least, of how people are going to cope with it.
Well, luckily, we're starting to feel some droplets of rain, and people are just desperate for there to be more of a downpour. Obviously, the evening's now cooling off. They are expecting the next few days to be cooler. But we're hearing politicians, the Mayor of London, headmasters of schools, owners of businesses, warning that this does look like it's becoming the new normal, and the country's going to need to find a way to adapt to these temperatures. Because unlike some other countries where maybe high 30 centigrade or up into the 40s might be more normal, England simply isn't built for that. You know, the capital especially, it's a lot of Victorian architecture that's not retrofitted with air conditioning. People are so hot, and the tarmac in the airfields or the train lines, all of that infrastructure is built within a certain span, and this is so much hotter than that we have buckling train tracks, we have melting airfields. It's simply not built for it, so they're going to have to try and act fast if these weather conditions are likely to be seen more in this country.
Yeah, none of that is a short-term fix for the moment. It's going to be a tough couple of days. I really appreciate you being with us, Bianca. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Bianca. get more now on that unfolding fire emergency in the UK, brought on by record-breaking temperatures. We're going live now to Europe correspondent Brett McLeod. Brett, I mean, we can't believe what we're seeing over here. You've got homes in London on fire.
It is extraordinary to be standing here on the outskirts of London talking about a wildfire destroying homes. The images you're seeing could be taken in any Australian summer, but this is summer in London now after the hottest day on record. This is the town of Wennington where a grass fire burnt several homes, at least 8 homes you understand have been badly damaged or destroyed, plus a lot of outside properties as well. It's about 300 people who live here. They've all been evacuated. Luckily, the weather has now turned significantly. London had its hottest day ever, 40.2 degrees. Britain had its hottest day ever, 40.3 degrees. Scotland too, its hottest day ever. That's the way the weather's gone the past couple of days. But just in the past couple of hours, the temperature has dropped significantly back to below 30. It's about 27 degrees now. So good news for firefighters as they bring this blaze under control. In fact, it looks like they've well and truly got it under control now, and they're starting to move some of that equipment out. But what a sight, and how extraordinary to think that we're watching these pictures out of London, but truly a sign that things have changed here.
Yeah, but still high 20s at 10 o'clock at night. There you go, Brett. Nice to talk to you. Thank you.